crimes, my rebellion, my sin, my anarchy. You understand that I rebelled against God. I did what I wanted, when I wanted, and God has forgiven me. And now He loves me. And now He has changed me. I've been born again. And I want that to happen to you, hate man, that you would be called love man, love man. That's when you're changed and you walk with God and you experience His love and His mercy. I mean, how long has it been? 30 years ago, I've preached here against you and told you about Christ. And I'm hoping that Jesus Christ will give you a revelation tonight to the preaching of the gospel. Faith would come, and that my words would have a part in your life, that you can enter into paradise, and that you and me, Mark, when we stand before God, we would stand before Jesus Christ, and our sins would be blotted out, and we would be forgiven. I mean, this is so incredible. I want you to taste it. Taste and see that the Lord is good. And how blessed is a man who walks with Him. I want you to walk with Him. I walk with God. I'm friends with God. I'm His slave. I stand on the corner. I'm a slave to God. I got a perfect master. My master takes care of me. You're a slave to Satan. And look what the master is doing to you. You're a slave to wickedness. Look what it's up. Wicked? Yes. You're destroying the temple of the Holy Spirit. Oh, I say what is wicked is your thought life and what you do in secret. I think, no, it's just the human nature. You have a nature that is bent on evil. Human nature. No, God calls it evil. You have fallen into sin. Sin. You have lied. Have you ever lied, Mark? Have you ever lied?
Everybody lies.
Oh, that is wrong. That is bad. That is sin. No, it's not good. I don't want you to lie to me, and I don't want to lie to you. Oh, sad. God calls it. There's a measure. There's a measure. And God has given us the measure. He's written His conscience on your heart. You have a conscience. You know when you lie. Say, no. Who gave you the conscience? Who said lying is wrong? Who said that having sex out of marriage is wrong? Oh, no. God said it. And that's the measure. You have to submit to it. He is the one that created you. He is the one that knows you. He's the one that walks with you.
He's your master.
Oh, I know. Your master's the devil. I said I'm a slave to righteousness. I'm a slave to God. He's an incredible master. He takes care of me. He loves me. He blesses me. He forgives me. He gives me peace. I have joy. Oh, look what Satan has done to you. Look what the devil has done for you. Oh, look at this. I tell you, he comes to steal, kill, and destroy you. And look what he's doing to you. Oh, look what I know. I stand out here in the post. Look at this. Look at God has made me, renewed my youth like the eagles. Oh, yes, God has done something in my life so incredible. I'm trying to describe it to you. And it's kind of indescribable. It's indescribable, but I can see obviously what Satan has done to you, Mark, for the last 15 years. Don't you see? I know him. I preached with them about 30 years ago. A hate man. Oh, yeah. That's when he wore women's clothes. Oh, yeah. Remember when you walked around like a woman? Oh, you're still trying to find out who you are. Your identity. What's the meaning of life? What's the purpose of it? You go to Yale, you finish, you get great grades, you're super intelligent, and look what has happened. Oh, I'm trying to get people to understand the end is near. The end, you're going to die. You're going to die. It could happen today. You're going to die. You're going to die. Do you not understand? It could happen today. It can happen today. I am going to transcend right into His presence. Absent from His body, I'm in the presence of God. Hey, I'm going to enter into paradise. I'm going to enter into that which is beautiful. You're going to enter into where? The lake of fire. You're going to enter into burning. You're going to be entering into torment. You're going to enter into darkness. I see. I know the terror of the Lord. I try to persuade men and women. I try to persuade you. That's why I'm here. I don't want you to burn in hell. I don't want you tortured in hell. Oh, you know it. You have a conscience and it bears witness against you. The courtroom of your mind says guilty. And that's why you smoke. That's why you suppress it, deny it, reject it. That's why you go down the path and you don't want to hear it. Oh, it's sad. It's sad. So what? So what? I care about my neighbor. I care about my neighbor. I'm concerned about my neighbor. There are people here. They don't even know who they are, where they're going, what the meaning of life. They think a president is going to change their life if they have Hillary Clinton or Donald Trump. Like, it's going to change your life? I mean, what's going to change? The only thing that can change your life is Jesus Christ being born again. The only thing that can change your life is that you repent of your sins and come to know Christ. Believing, receiving faith, receiving peace, receiving joy, His grace. Oh, God that comes in like a flood and He changes your life. Supernatural power of God. You need to be saved, delivered, redeemed. You need Christ in your life to forgive, but you must repent. You must repent looking at porno. You must repent masturbating. You must repent smoking marijuana. You must repent of your filthy imagination, your pride. You must repent. You must repent of your filthy language. You must repent. It's wrong. It's wrong. What you're doing is wicked in the sight of God. Oh, the eyes of the Lord behold the evil and the good. God says sex is beautiful under holy matrimony. The marriage bed is undefiled, but all whores and whoremongers will be judged. I'm telling you the truth, man. I care about you. Someone's got to tell you the truth. Someone's got to warn you. I'm warning. I'm preaching Christ and warning every man. Jesus Christ, He is the way. He is the truth. He is the life. There's no way unto the Father except through Him. Jesus Christ, salvation and no one else. No other name under heaven by which you can be saved. You need to be saved. You're a sinner. You've sinned against God. You've broken His law. I'm forgiven. I've been set free. I've been born again. Reconciled. Redeemed. Regeneration. Converted. I've been like a little child. Oh, let's give Him thanks. Let's give Him thanks. Jesus Christ, the God-man. Let's give Him thanks. The resurrection and the life. Let's give Him thanks. He is the one that will return in flaming fire, taking vengeance on all those who know not God. Is that you? Is that you? Because you know not God? You're not born again? You're not a Christian? Jesus Christ not Lord of your life? You're a slave to the devil? Oh, smoke another blunt. You'll feel better. Hey, eat another hit of acid. Oh, you'll feel better. You'll feel better after drinking another beer. You have no peace. The wicked have no peace. The wicked are never satisfied. They never are. See, I have satisfaction because I'm in the presence of God. The Bible says that in His presence there's fullness of joy. And at His right hand there's pleasures forevermore. Oh, His path drips with abundance. Oh, when you walk with God. Oh, when you obey Christ. When you experience the forgiveness of sins filled with the Spirit of the living God, and you're walking down the street in communion, fellowship. Oh, I know this is foreign to you, Mark. This is foreign to the hate man. You live in hate. You live in darkness. You live in loneliness and insecurity and emptiness. You do. You do. I know you. Oh, but when you come into the presence of God,
come out.
Oh, you know, you have to come and see your nothingness. You are nothing. Your emptiness. You are nothing. You're hollow. I agree. I have to be refilled every day. I am hollow. You're right. Hey, I love it because I know that the source of all life flows into me. The source of life every day. I'm dependent upon that source. I know. Apart from Him, I am nothing. But see, you lean on your own understanding. I know. Yeah, you think you have something in your pride, your intellect. You think you're something that you're not. You've been deceived by the devil. You've been blinded by the god of this world, Lucifer, who's blinded the eyes of the unbelieving. Just like this guy, he's blinded. He's blinded. He thinks he's cool because he's got hair, long hair. I tell you, everyone lives in a fantasy. It's a mirage. And it's not real. It's not true. Truth is what is real. Real. Take the mask off. Take it off and let us see the real pain. The pain, the hurt, the lies, the emptiness of this life. Jesus Christ has cleansed, healed, the bitterness, everything been washed clean. I stand here forgiven. I stand here. I want you to experience that right now. Right now, I want you to repent. Think differently about it. I want you to repent. You got to repent or you'll perish. Oh, you need to repent. God, give them a revelation. God, illuminate, reveal. God, transform, change them. In the name of Jesus, deliver them from the demons and the pride and the arrogance and the sin. Oh. If only God would do this miracle in you as he has done in me. Oh, if God would choose you, not for the lake of fire. I'm telling you, you don't choose him. He chooses you. Oh, God. God is the one. And maybe you. Or maybe your God, Guava, or the great pumpkin. Remember that one? Oh, you lost him.
That's right.
See? See? He's giving you no life. All those years, man. No life, the great pumpkin. Now, wait till I go tell Larry. I can't believe it. I know. Pick it. Yeah, I'm just like the rest of them out here. I have the truth. I know I have the resurrection and the life, the one who rose. You can't get rid of the Bible. You can't. It's alive. It's living. It speaks. It comes. And no, it's not. You can't get rid of it. You can't get rid of it. It's still speaking. It continues to speak. It's going to speak for eternity. Eternity. Oh, you kidding? No.
It's
no. Oh, it transforms people's life, and you won't read it because you're scared. You're scared to read it because you know it's going to read you. You know if you read it and it comes alive, you're going to have to make some changes, and you don't like because you love your sin. You love your lifestyle of sin. Oh, you're not. Ah, oh, you fake it. You're such a fake, man. Such a fake. Yeah.
Gotten some calls about you using the speaker system.
Oh, okay. You can't do that.
You can't use the speaker system.
Okay.
So if you want to just tone it down for a little bit,
okay,
that'd be great. All right.
Yeah. Hey, how you doing?
You guys can right. You guys can talk. You just can't use the amplified thing.
Okay.
Hey, y'all don't believe
hey.
Me. Jesus.
All right. Yeah, you want to ask?
Yeah. I'm sorry, officer. I don't mean to interrupt, but he's only we do this every year.
Well, all year.